Yeah. Welcome, everyone, to another Blues Zeppelin on Radio Bern Rabe 95.6 megahertz in Bern, Switzerland. Air date for this program is Sunday, the 26th of October, 2014. The Blues Zeppelin is also heard on Saturday nights on Radio Laura in Zurich at 97.5 megahertz. WRFI Community Radio in the Finger Lakes region of upstate New York at 88.1 FM in Ithaca, 91.9 FM in Watkins Glen, and three times a week around the world on bluesandrootsradio.com. On today's program, we are going to have a live interview with Mina Kreil and Chris Fillmore. I understand that Mina has a sore throat fever, so I think we're going to do the interview with Chris Fillmore. They have an upcoming gig at the Mully Hunzika on the 8th of November. That's a Saturday night, and we'll be giving away three pairs of tickets for that show.
Radio Rabe
95.6 95.6
95.6
Rabe.
You make me think about you and me. The way you talk, ooh, the way you look at me. Is there something going on? Tell me, is there something going wrong? Thank you.
That's the title track from the new CD from Mina Kreil and the Chris Fillmore Band. And on the phone, we have the wonderful guitarist, Chris Fillmore. Hiya, Chris.
Hi, Mark. I'm fine. How are you?
Good. Thank you so much for coming on the Blues Zeppelin on a Sunday. I understand Mina's not feeling too well today.
Yeah, Mina got sick. She's very sorry, and she's in bed. She got temperature and the cold, and she's very sorry that she can't be here with you today. But I should say hi to you and all the listeners.
Yeah, thank you for coming on. This is the third CD that you guys have put out on Roof Records. The first CD was called Try Me, the second one Feel Me, and the third one Tell Me. You guys are really putting out a great sound. Not only in Europe, you guys have toured as well extensively in the U.S.
We've been in the U.S., yeah. We played a few shows there, yeah, in 2012 and last year, 2013.
Great. How did the two of you get together to make such great music?
Well, Mina and I, we met when we were about 15, 16 years old. Actually, on our way to the school that we attended back then, and I had my band, and I knew that she was singing, and someday I just asked her and invited her to a jam session, and yeah, that's basically the way it started, and yeah, we're doing it together ever since.
That's great, and you guys have a gig coming up just outside Bern in Rubingen on Saturday, the 8th of November. At the Molly Hunzica. You guys have played there before.
We played there before, but it was not a show of ours. It was the Roof Blues Caravan, you know, which Mina attended in 2010. And she played there. And I was with her on guitar on that night, but there was also Coco Montoya and Shakura Seida, if I'm right. And,
right.
Yeah.
Her singing just seems to get better and better over time. She's really developed into a great, not only a great blues rocker, but she can do these ballads wonderfully as well.
Yeah, right. Yeah, that's what I think too. I think she and all of us, we made a lot of experiences in the last couple of years, and we learned a lot, and also to how to use our instruments, also her voice as an instrument, you know, she improved very much what she thinks about herself. Yeah.
You not only play electric, you also play acoustic guitar, a slide as well on some tracks.
Right. Exactly. Yeah.
What do you prefer to play, or is it all good for you?
It's all good because, you know, everything is different, and I'm just looking at the song and think what fits best to create a certain emotion, you know, and that's how I pick my guitar, so that's when I decide.
Great.
Electric or acoustic.
We're going to hear another song now called Bring Me the Water. You want to tell us something about this?
Well, Bring Me the Water, this one got a kind of road movie feeling, that's what I think, and on this one I played the slide guitar, so yeah, it's from the latest record, Tell Me.
Great. So we're going to play that, and then we're going to come back for some more talk. So stay
Great.
Tuned. Blue Zeppelin, special guest Chris Fillmore from Mina Kreil and the Chris Fillmore Band.
Thank you.
was blowing, and the night was dark and cold. I hear the voices calling, they call out for me. But if you really wanna know, that's one thing that I need. All that I wanna do is put chains around my hands. But I don't wanna be guided by voices I don't understand.
And the Chris Fillmore Band from their latest release, Tell Me, on Roof Records. And Chris, there's a beautiful photograph of you and Mina standing in the middle of Beale Street.
Right, yeah, on the back cover, yeah.
Were you there for recording or visiting the IBCs? What was your reason for the trip to...
Both, actually. We've been to Memphis two times now. So first time in 2009 when we recorded our first album, Try Me, with Jim Gaines. This was the first time in Memphis. And we went there again last year in 2013 and attended the IBC. And, yeah, that's when we took the picture. And the reason why we put this picture on the cover is... Because the whole trip to Memphis and the southern states of the U.S. was such an inspiration for us for the new album, so that we thought it fits for an album. album
was
cover.
The inspiration hearing a lot of the bands in the U.S.? Was it meeting the musicians? What was the inspiration, actually?
It was also meeting the musicians, but also the... How should I describe it? It's the whole spirit that is in the air out there. You know, it's like the people, how people are living there, and the whole society, and I don't know. It's hard to explain, but it's different, like in Europe or in Austria, where we are based. So, and it was just a huge inspiration to find all these places where all this is historical places where all the our heroes came from, you know what I mean, like John Lee Hooker and Muddy Waters, Elvis Presley, and all those guys, you know. This was a great inspiration.
Yeah, Chris, how did you, growing up in Austria, how did you discover these heroes?
Well, it's a good question. My family was always very a musical family. There was always music around, you know. My mother and my father always made music by themselves, not professionally, but at home. And so music was always there. And I remember a key point to me was when I was 8 years old. And I remember I got up in the morning, went downstairs in the living room, and the radio was on. And there was Elvis Presley on the radio, and... Of course, I didn't know the name Elvis Presley back then, but I listened to it and recorded it on a tape recorder, and my mom later told me it's Elvis Presley, and I was just fascinated of that groove and that feeling, and that's how it all started for me musically, you know what I mean? And because of Elvis, then I found out of all the other guys like John Lee Hooker and Stevie Ray Vaughan and you understand?
Yeah, yeah. I guess that the Austrian radio was playing some of these guys.
I think it was a German radio station, but I can't remember exactly. But it's not too much blues on Austrian radio stations, unfortunately.
Okay. You have another gig. There are two gigs coming up in the first weekend of November. On Friday, the 7th of November, you're playing at the Box Blues Night in Canton,
right.
Zurich. That's a festival running from the 7th to the 9th of November. And then on Saturday, the 8th of November, you're playing at the Mully Hunzika just outside Bern in Rubigen. And Bianca Dost from Roof Records has been very kind, and she's offered three pairs of tickets to give away. So the way we're going to do this today is please send me an email at blueszeppelin@raba.ch. Send me an email at blueszeppelin@raba.ch. One word, blueszeppelin. And I will contact you about putting you on the guest list if you win those tickets. Chris, there's a track on this CD, which is absolutely, for me, the killer track. It's called Enough is Enough. And it really shows what kind of a guitar player you really are.
No, thank you.
You like belting it out on this CD. Enough is Enough is the track. On the previous CD, Feel Me, there's a wonderful track called Moving On, and you do a wonderful guitar solo on there as well. So we're going to hear We're going to hear that now as Enough is Enough, and then come back. This is a very special Blues Zeppelin with my incredibly talented guest, Chris Fillmore from Mina Kreil and the Chris Fillmore Band.
Color to be.
Nina Kreil and the Chris Fillmore Band really delivering the goods on that track, Enough is Enough. And I got to tell you, I think it's going to be more than enough at the Mully Hunzica in Rubigen on the 8th of November. There are two gigs coming up the 7th of November as part of Box Blues Night. That's Box in Canton, Zurich. And on Saturday, the 8th of November at the Mully Hunzica. Chris, great, great stuff. You know, it's hard to do three good CDs back-to-back.
It is a challenge, of course, yeah. But, you know, we got a lot of support, and yeah, I hope we did it well. So, but there's also a difference. Maybe let's talk a little bit about the new album. There's a difference because on the latest one, we did it all by ourselves. Which means on the first two albums we were not too much involved in the whole production, you know what I mean?
Right.
Because Roof Records, the record label, made all the arrangements, told us which musicians we should use and which studio, which producer, which was great back then because we learned a lot and everything, but now we felt we are ready to do it by ourselves, and maybe that's why it sounds a little different than the two previous ones. At least that's what people say. I don't know.
Well, it sounds great, and those gigs are coming up. We're unfortunately quickly running out of time because I want to play the last track, This Is My Will, from the CD. I want to wish you good times and a gute Besserung. We want to send to Mina Kreil. We hope that she's feeling better real soon.
I'll tell her.
And thank you very much, Chris, for coming on today.
Thank you for having us on the show, man. Thank you, Mark.
Blues Zeppelin is produced at the studios of Radio Bern, Rabe in Bern, Switzerland. The Blue Zeppelin can also be heard on Radio Laura, 97.5 megahertz in Zurich, and on WRFI Community Radio in upstate New York, 88.1 FM in Ithaca, New York, 91.9 in Watkins Glen, and three times a week around the world. Don't miss it on bluesandrootsradio.com. Once again, happy birthday, Stevie. See you in a couple of weeks. And thank you so much for listening and supporting Community Radio.